2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
Now, our guest at this time, our favourite chef, the only chef we put our dinner in the hands of to trust, is Gavin Forman. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Mark. How are you?
Look, it's a case of who's avoiding who today. You're all the way over there and I'm all the way over here because I'm not well. But you've got your glasses on because you've had a big night. Is that what's happened?
No. I burst a blood vessel in my eye and it's quite unattractive to the visuals.
Well, I'll tell you what, there is a camera right behind you. So why don't you just, for those who look at this later, why don't you just take the glasses up or off and just sort of look into the camera there. That's the one.
Yeah. Very attractive. I'll stick to the glasses, I think.
That'll get the hits up on the later, that's for sure. Look, you mentioned before we started today that you even have some of your friends now wanting to find out which torturous meal you're going to give me of a week.
Yeah.
That's a bit rude.
I got a message this morning from a chef friend in Dubbo, going, have you tried them with tripe yet? Can we bring tripe in? They're out there and they're after you, Mark. I'm your protector. You didn't even know this.
I really didn't. I have one friend here and it's our chef, Gavin Forman. Look, today you have been super kind, though.
I have.
We've got the recipe up already at 2NURFM.com and the Morning Show page, but some lovely looking cornbread.
Yeah, we're using polenta, fine polenta, sifted through flour. The one nasty, and it's probably there's a lot of sugar.
Oh, that's not all right.
That's all right. You're good with sugar.
Totally fine.
And a little bit of sambal again. And we've had our continuous battle with chili.
We have. Every second week is chili week now.
So there's a little bit in it. But as I said, on the recipe, as the philosophy with food, if you like a certain ingredient, increase it. If you like the flavor, increase it. If you don't, take it out. So
how much sugar is in this thing?
When I make the big lot for the restaurant, we put 1.3 kilos in.
Oh, my goodness.
But we get 48 serves. So I've multiplied that down. So if you multiply it up, down, it'll work.
Okay.
So
let's try it. You'll have to keep talking, because I've got to
move. I'll keep talking. I'll butter your bread for you. How's that?
What? Hang on.
There you go. Because everything's better with butter, you know. I actually have a T-shirt that says, keep calm and add butter.
Yeah, I like that. And so we've got sugar, we've got butter, we've got all the other ingredients.
Yeah.
So let's have a taste while you keep talking.
Not a problem. It's a very nice bread. It can be dense, it can be light. It depends on how you like it. As I said, you can leave the sugar out and it's not as sweet. You can use self-raising flour instead of plain flour and take the bicarb out. You can mess around with a lot of the recipes I put up and nothing has to be exact, except things like brulees, which is why pastry chefs are a separate breed. They live in kitchens with normal chefs, but they have an unhealthy obsession with spatulas and weighing stuff. So I don't like to be as exact in my measurements. I like to be able to throw a bit of this in, throw a bit of that in, and yes.
This is really, really nice.
You sound surprised. Every time I bring you something nice, you go, well, that's really... Why did you do that? I'll have to take a survey now of all my friends and go, right, what can we come up with that's the worst?
No, I think we've been there. Now, this is really nice. It's just a really nice taste. It doesn't feel heavy in any way.
Yeah, and making it's easy. You just mix all your dry, mix all your wet, mix together and bake.
Sounds pretty good. And it's not sort of, like I said, not really sugary, not really...
No.
Heavy. It's really light. I like it.
The secret to my one is actually the mozzarella. I use mozzarella cheese in it instead of the level of fat. So I use the fat from the cheese rather than extra butter or anything like that.
Okay. And you've done all that with only one eye working.
Oh, yes. And it's not a very attractive eye either.
No. Keep those glasses on. He's got those lovely John Lennon style on.
I know. People keep calling me Jesus on the way in.
Fair call. Thanks, Gav. We'll talk to you next week. Next time, who knows what you'll bring in. Next time.
I know. Be afraid.
You've been nice. You've got to be naughty next time around.
Absolutely.
All righty. It's